One day, I will get that one-up mushroom. That day is coming soon, but not quite yet. Hey everybody, this is Spiraling Helix. Welcome back to Super Mario Galaxy. In the last episode, we actually had quite an easy time in the Honey Hive purple coin star. And we explored a lot more of the engine. In this episode, we will explore more of the engine room. But I think I'll start off this episode, actually, by doing the Hungry Luma. Because I'm already outside, and I just thought, why not? 1,000 star bits. Ooh, hopefully I have enough for the next one. Because that's getting pretty high up there. Yeah, I should have enough. That's it, I'm stuffed. Here we go. Transform! And by that I mean die! But with that, a new galaxy has appeared, the Sand Spiral Galaxy. So let's get right into it. And this galaxy, I actually really, I find it interesting, choosing a favorite snack. This galaxy, you'll notice there's ghosts and stuff, but see, there's two power-ups. So I actually get the choice between what I want to choose here. And Kamek. Can I go? Oh, darn it. We can kill Kamek quick enough before. Or Magic Uber, I should say, before it goes over there. One of these is Kamek. Which one? We don't know. And no, no, no! I'm calling this one Kamek because this one killed me. And it shall pay. Yeah, I'm not gonna hit it that time. But let's actually do this properly. There we go. You deserve that. So we have the choice of B Mario. And what do you have to say? These yellow mushrooms are super delicious. Not like I've been sitting here all day eating them. I mean, they do respawn after you eat, like, lose them. This white mushroom is yummy. So we can either kill ourselves and become Boo Mario, or buzz around like B Mario. Well, I feel like we don't see enough of Boo Mario, so I'm gonna choose Boo Mario. Now, it is worth noting, I could go B Mario, go part way down and then switch. But, actually, that is actually quite interesting. I think they want you to choose Boo Mario. Ooh, that's a lot more obstacles for Boo Mario, in my opinion, anyway. Well, then again, you can't fly endlessly as B Mario. I wonder what hits up if I get hit by one of these. What happens if I get hit by one of these? No, no, no! I did not think that would happen. I thought it would, like, just go right through me, because I'm a ghost for some reason. Anyway, I'll get you Maybe I won't get you this time. Anyway, so I went through most of that as Boo Mario. So I'm still going through it as Boo Mario. We don't see enough of Mario when he's a Boo. We've seen plenty of B Mario. Maybe a bit too much. Thankfully, there is one other power-up we have seen barely any of. Spring Mario. Worst power-up in the game. It's not that, yes, but it's fine. But, got some bats here, but who cares? That Sling Star, who cares about that? I can fly. Here we go. And I guess, oh! I guess if you keep your B Mario all the way, because, by the way, the moonlight, it's light. That's why I turned back. I guess if I keep B Mario, I can just fly over there. It's bright because of the moonlight. Oh, I did just say that, but I guess with B Mario, I can just fly over. But why would I do that? This is way more fun. So we've gone through the sand, now we'll go through the spiral. And I actually, usually when you head out here first, it's the blue part and you get on there. But I actually, actually skipped heaps because I went on the green part. But let's try that again. And I guess we're getting on the green part as well. No, oh come on. Why did I choose then to jump? Why on earth? I'm losing a lot of lives lately. Let's wait a bit this time and then move onwards. And you can see there's more stars to refill you of your power just so you can run through these mines. Especially on bits like this where, let's say there is, unless you just go under it like that. No, 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 no! I feel like Star Mario is a little bit of a trap. Although I'm glad I chose Boo Mario now. Wahoo! Ooh, I feel like I can just jump straight there. I'm gonna try it. Yes, so that gravity pull-in was actually very small. But with that, we get our star after several deaths. But with that, we've got our star from our hungry Luma. And our Luma is not so hungry anymore. I don't even think I've made a point of showing the small things. I thought Rosalina had something to say for a moment, but you don't, because I just got a star back. Galaxy complete. Save your game, no thanks. And while we're down here, let's do our purple coin comet for today, and we will be finishing off the fountain. So let's head all the way over to Battle Rock Galaxy. Here we go. What on earth is a blue star doing now? I feel like I'm making points here that I've already made earlier in this series, but who cares? I don't care. And I'm sure you guys wouldn't care so much. I thought, oh great, Papa Colin, guess I'm not doing anything. But that's what I'm here for. Anyway, let's do this purple comment. And this is the third thing that I've mentioned about purple comments. The first one, I think, was just, it's relaxed, you can get them all. Second one, you have a time limit. Third one, though, you'll notice this is on an auto-scroller part. So I think there'll be a sign or a robot or something. Yes. But I could be wrong. Hopefully I'm not wrong. The cannons, I thought they don't fire for a moment. Now, I'm pretty sure there's 110 or 120 purple coins on this star. And you only need 100 to obviously get the star. So you don't have to collect every purple coin. Of course, I will make it my mission in case I'm wrong and there are only 100. But I'm too busy concentrating to really talk. But no, I shall talk. Let's get a lot of these purple coins. We'll get all that we can. Let's just assume there's 100 for now. And no, grab this one. And get. I guess I'll grab a life room. I don't know how it will help me. I mean, the cannons aren't that big of a problem, and the lasers aren't either, especially when all the purple coins are on the opposite. Well, I was gonna say, especially when all the purple coins are on the opposite side, but I guess not. No, 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 no. There we go. I'm not missing a single one. Because now I do have a bit of a feeling that there's only 100. Grab this, but don't get led astray. Don't go down there. Yahoo! And I guess there's only 100 purple coins. With that, that's the last one. And there we go. In case you're wondering, this robot is here. He has a very good reason for being here. Hey, hey, very nice. I could have sworn there were more purple coins in this starter nap, but I guess that's only actually in Mario Galaxy 2. But with that, we've got a star. And I'll quickly note, let's say I did miss a purple coin there, just one maybe, and I was very annoyed. Now, I could keep running into cannons and electrical things to kill myself, because gravity won't let me fall off the edge. Or I could just talk to that robot at the end, Galaxy complete, and Dome complete. Save game, no thanks, we'll head back to the engine now. But if I talk to that robot at the end, he'll go, "What? You didn't get 100 coins? Well, that's not good enough," or something. Or better try harder next time, or something like that. And then you'll just die. You will. It's like talking to the robots after you do the trash cleaning secret mission. You will just die. That couch is the comfiest. Of course, you say that every time. But I don't care, because I'm heading back to the engine. And that 1-Up is still up there. Rawr! But here we go, into the engine. And what shall we do this time? Well, we have more stars in here. We have the bonus stars, but not in Sea Slide Galaxy. So let's head to the Sea Slide Galaxy. Our bonus star has to be in this one. So let's have a look out for that. Here we go. The Silver Stars of Sea Slide. And if you look around, there's quite a lot happening actually around the Sea Slide Galaxy, and it looks like we'll be climbing a tree. Do you know what that means? More B Mario. Yay! But we're not doing that star. Wait, everyone here is helping us look for those silver stars. What are bees doing? Every worker bee, even worker bees get holidays too, you know. Let's grab this shell though. So let's just keep note of one. There's one silver star up on that. And there is one on... Okay, that was terribly slow. And there is one on the tree. Looks like there's one all the way up there by the toad ship. And in this one, you actually get characters, because they are very spread out, you actually get characters going, "Hey, there's one over here, but I don't know how to reach it," or something like that. What do you have to say? Oh, you're not that same penguin, are you? Could have sworn I saw something on top of that massive mangrove. So there's one up there, one up there, one up there, one up there, and one up here. But what do you have to say? Cannons, though, a blast. And I forgot it was actually a hungry Luma. I thought it was just something else. How many do you need? 40. I don't have enough. I guess I'll be going back this way. Good thing I've been collecting star bits as I go. And with that, almost. Four more star bits. There we go. That should be enough. Perfect. A little bit more, but... Let's go feed this hungry Luma, shall we? No, no, no! I knew this would... I'm gonna feed everything I have to it now. I knew this would happen. Feed me! I will, but I... Oh! There we go. Got plenty. I won't mess up this time. I knew it would happen at some point. Look at its chubby little hands now. There we go. Just one more. And he's stuffed. Here we go. Transform! Into a black hole? Oh, it was around the black hole. A new planet was born as a star killed itself. Luma, I guess. So we want to shoot ourselves to this instead. And I want to hit just one panel. Come on. Which one? Oh, that was very accurate. And you are timed for this, but you want to hit every single music note, which is on every single panel. I'm so glad I didn't hit that. Every single panel. And basically, just you move around the whole thing like this. This is the best way to do it, in my opinion. We'll end off there, I think. Yeah, so now I move around this way. So yeah, just go around this. Makes it a bit easier. Head around here. Grab these. Almost there. Timer's getting quicker, but we're fine. And with that, the black hole just disappears. And gets reborn into a power star. And with that, long jump. We've cleared out this whole planet. And let's see how long this takes. Here we go. And this one. There we go. So this one's a lot more fun with gravity. But with that, we got a star. What's that one called? Harisco was the other one. This one was called the... Hurry, he's hungry. Who's... Well, I guess that's the hungry Luma, but... Was the black hole hungry? We didn't really feed it. And... Ooh, no, we're not doing this. This elsewhere, if the purple comet appears in the way of another star, I'd be very annoyed. But let's actually do the silver stars this time. And we've seen where a few are. I'll be able to get one, like, almost straight away up here. Because all we need to do is grab this speed power up and then head up onto that cloud. So clouds are a new thing with... No, go that way. With B Mario introduced into this galaxy. Basically, also, solid leaves, thank goodness. Clouds are just moving platforms for the big young one. That's basically it. So, with that... Okay, so here's the really stupid and dangerous thing. Never mind. Still being stupid and dangerous though. Don't know why. Let's stop that. But I want to grab this bee. No, I want to go in the cannon first. But I thought you could walk around on that edge. I think the outside edge you can. But let's just shoot at the ship. We'll be safe that way. I almost thought it just knocks us off. No one's even in the ship. And that thing starts how we get back. And this is how you're meant to grab this one up over here as well. And doo-doo-doo. That's not the jingle, but oh well. Slingstar back to the main planet. And I don't need this cannon anymore. I don't want to use it in case I mess something up really badly. But I wonder how on Earth we're going to get to that middle planet there. We haven't seen a way of doing that yet. Oh well, slowly hover over here. I could have probably done that a bit better. And you'll notice there are quite a few Slingstars like that. I think they'll mainly lead back to where you first started in this level. Why is that showing? I'm pretty sure... Oops. Can I grab that? I guess I have to jump on it. There we go. That was weird. Oh, I guess you can't carry it as B-Mario. What's all the buzz about the bee mushroom? Yeah, there's a chest over here. Just switch that. That was it.
Wahoo!
But if I head over here and climb up these blocks, there's one up on this tree. Well, if I can... No, if I can jump. There we go. Also, you go straight through the leaves. And buzz up again with that. And we know it. The other two, it's on the tree and up in the middle. So let's just go all the way over here. So we have B-Mario. Let's approach this tree. Let's make our way up it, and looks like there's another Sling Star down there. I think they all lead back to the start. Maybe there's one somewhere that leads there. But that whole stretch there is like all underwater. Why is there a bee power up all the way up the tree here? I mean, you have to be a bee to get up the this far on the tree. And, oh, get off him. Didn't see him for a moment. But you do cut it a little bit close. What did I take damage on again? Oh right, it was the Koopa. Wait, that's the first time I've taken damage on the Koopa. Oh well. Now head down here to this mechanical thing. There's gotta be one there. Whoa, Cameron! What are you doing? And Guppy! Guppy, our good buddy, old pal. Guppy, seriously, you need to be a bit more careful. I checked around, but there's nothing between here and the lighthouse. See, I told you. Good work, Guppy, you're actually helpful. This ought to take you to the captain in one shot. I'm pretty sure, yeah, we got that one already. What do you have to say? I bet you can ride this. Thank you. But if we spot in this one up... Whatever that was. But we get this awesome water jet. This is so awesome. Unfortunately, that's it. And are you still there? I think it just disappeared. But that brings us to this planet in the middle. And this has a lot of crabs on it. And the hidden thing. Here we go. Collect all of these for a prize. I think it's just a one-up though. Yeah, I don't care about that. Oh, Gramps, you're here too. Everyone's here. There's all kinds of hubbub in Seaside. What's going on? Die, crab. You leave Gramps alone. Penguru's place. Oh, and your name's Penguru, huh? What on earth are you doing up here? Get down! And with that right in the middle, I guess that one turn is gone. We've got this. The final, I almost said the sixth. The fifth and final Silver Star of the Seaslide Galaxy. So many S's. And boom! Oh, I thought I hit the guy for a moment. But that just brings us here. I don't want to be here. Oh. I'm actually curious. Oh, wait, that launch star only appeared once we got the Silver Star. I was gonna say, what happens if I fly back without grabbing? What do you have to say, Captain Toad? Look, it's a Power Star! Don't space out and forget to grab it! We got a Power Star! And, ooh. This episode's... I want to do another star, but I don't know if it's... I feel like it might be a little bit too long. Let's just extend the episode a little bit then. So we've got one more star to put under our overalls or our hat. So just got... Oh, we have another one in Toy Time as well. But we are going to be doing Bowser Jr.'s Lava Reactor. Or is it just like Bowser... whatever? I don't know. King Caliente's Spicy Return. Demonstration of a ripoff. The first planet is basically the same as Megaleg's moon. Like the first planet there. You get a Bullet Bill to chase you, and it'll blow up the launch. Yes. Yeah. And these stones here actually show you the way to go. Let's knock you guys. No! Yeah, knock those guys out. So, King Caliente, you might remember from the Good Egg Galaxy. That's how long ago it was. He was that weird octopus theme bob that shot coconuts at us. None shall stand in my way to the Bullet Bills. Die. 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 And you'll fall down. And with this, we now have a Bullet Bill chasing us. Again, don't run too quickly, he'll just hit the ground. Which is annoying. But jumping here helps quite a bit. And I really... No, don't hit it. That's another thing with Bullet Bills, as you just saw. They like to home in on cages, and they'll stop chasing you completely for a moment. So he almost did. But here we go, and this isn't actually the boss yet. Bowser Jr., you've stepped up your game. Well, I guess he sort of did that in the second one. Oh, I got one of them. There we go, coconuts! Fiery coconuts. But King Caliente's spicy return, let's launch off! With our life stream, by the way, we got. And here we go, this looks more like it. Ha! If I give up any more Grand Stars, my dad's gonna get mad! So this calls for my ultimate weapon. Give him some heat, King Caliente! Oh, there we go. He's one spicy octopus. Looks a bit different too, just a color palette. Although the platforms you're on do sink, you can just keep jumping on them like this though. And boom! And he's already deflecting! Oh, wow. Okay, there's a specific place in the panels I want to stand. I think it's... ah, this one. Okay. Where the three panels are touching each other like that. That's... I feel like this is the best place. I think there's another one over there. But where the three panels are... go away! Stupid flame thing. Here we go, coconut one. Coconut... oh no! Oh well, guess who's doing this game? Don't spawn. Okay, thanks. Coconut one. Oh, these guys just continue spawning. Coconut two. And that's strong. No! Oh, that was close. Oh, that was close. But with that, we have taken down King Caliente! There's our grand star. And these suddenly don't sink anymore. What is with my pointer? Anyway. Whatever that was. We got a grand star! So let's head back to the observatory. And I think there's only one grand star left in the game. Currently in the possession of the Koopa King Bowser himself. In the center of the universe, as well as Peach. But with that, the core is almost glowing white. And with that, we have now unlocked our final dome. After this teleport, and that island now, and another teleport, there's our final dome. Da 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 da. Sorry. Yay, galaxy complete! More star bits. You discovered a new galaxy. All of them in the new dome you can't actually see yet. Save game, no, and Rosalina's not even gonna tell us about this new dome. So why don't I just go up there and check it out before we end off the episode? While we're heading up there, there is something I'd like to point out though. So let's just head straight up and grab into that. Head straight up this new teleport here. It's pink now. And this island here, this little house, I'm not going to go in, but this is the gate. That will actually lead us to the Gateway Galaxy, the very first galaxy in the game that you might, may or may not remember playing. This is the garden. It's a secret room. I was going to call it the bedroom, but that was the fourth dome. But I just want to head round here and hit this teleport. This brings us all the way down into the garage. Probably could have used that when we were finishing up the fountain and terrace, but lets us see our good pal Luigi. He's not helping us anymore. But with that, we have finally defeated Bowser Jr. for good, I think it is now. And in the last dome we have available, I will get started there next episode, right after I do a purple comet. And I think just one more star in the Toy Time Galaxy. Oh, and Bonefin Galaxy. But with that, this episode has already gone long enough. We now have a complete observatory. And we have almost completed the engine. In the next episode, we're gonna do all that stuff I've already listed off. So, this is Spiraling Helix, signing out. Bye-bye.